The Globe, a Model of the Earth. Introduction. Our Earth is one of the 8 planets in the solar system. It is a unique planet because of the presence of life on it. Life is possible on this planet because of the presence of air and water. In the olden days, it was believed that the Earth was flat. People thought that if they traveled too far to the edges, they would fall off this flat surface. Philosophers and explorers such as Pythagoras, Aristotle, Magellan and Copernicus changed the opinion of people about the Earth, which they said was round. Sir Isaac Newton suggested that the Earth was not a perfect sphere, Globe. A globe is a spherical representation of the Earth. It represents the Earth in a simple and accurate way. A globe, being spherical, serves as a good model to help us to visualize the Earth and its surface. A major part of the Earth is underwater. The large water bodies are called oceans. The 5 major oceans on the Earth are the Pacific Ocean, the Atlantic Ocean, the Indian Ocean, the Southern Ocean and the Arctic Ocean. The large land masses on the Earth are called continents. The 7 continents of our Earth are Asia, Europe, North America, South America, Africa, Australia and Antarctica. The globe shows us the shapes and the locations of the continents, oceans and seas on the Earth. It also helps us to understand the Earth's movement on its axis and around the Sun. We can see only half of the globe at a time. To see the other half, we have to turn it around. It can be turned around on a line passing through it. This line is called the axis. The 2 ends of the axis are called the poles. The North Pole is situated at the top of the globe and the South Pole is situated at the bottom of the globe. In between the poles, there is an imaginary circle called the equator, which is 0 degrees. The equator divides the Earth into 2 equal halves, the Northern Hemisphere and the Southern Hemisphere. Hemi means half. The part north of the equator is called the Northern Hemisphere, NH, and the part south of the equator is called the Southern Hemisphere, SH. Parallels of latitudes. If you look at the globe, you will see many lines running parallel to the equator. That is, they are full circles. They run from east to west. They are numbered from the equator, which starts at 0 degree. The poles are 90 degree each. The North Pole is marked as 90 degree north and the South Pole as 90 degree south. They never meet one another as they are parallels. These lines are called lines of latitudes or the parallels of latitudes. The equator is the longest of the parallels and thus is called the Great Circle. There are some other important parallels. These are marked and named as under. 1. 23 degree and a half degree north, Tropic of Cancer, lies in the Northern Hemisphere. 2. 23 and a half degrees south, Tropic of Capricorn, lies in the Southern Hemisphere. 3. 66 and a half degree north, Arctic Circle, lies in the Northern Hemisphere. 4. 66 and a half degrees south, Antarctic Circle, lies in the Southern Hemisphere. These important parallels help in dividing the Earth into various heat zones. Meridians of longitude. If you look at the globe, you will find semicircles joining the North Pole and the South Pole. The longitudes are 360 degree in number and all are equal in length. These lines are also called the meridians of longitude. In 1884, all the countries of the world decided that the meridian passing through the observatory at Greenwich near London in the United Kingdom, UK, would be taken as the starting point. It is marked as 0 degrees. This is called the Greenwich or the prime meridian. Locating a place. To locate a place, we must know both its latitude and longitude, because the point at which these two lines intersect each other will be the location of that place. The meridian passing through Greenwich near London in UK is marked as 0 degrees. There are 180 degree longitudes to the east of the prime meridian, and similarly there are 180 degree longitudes to the west of the prime meridian. The meridians numbered as 0 degree and 180 degree join to form a full circle around the earth. They divide the earth into two equal halves named as the eastern and the western hemispheres. The meridians which are to the east of prime meridian are marked as E degree and those to the west as W degree. For example, India is located to the east of the prime meridian and the meridian of Jaipur is 75 degree east. The latitudes and the longitudes cross each other and form a network. This network is called grid. The grid helps us in locating different places. Time zones. A time zone is a division on the earth more or less bounded by 15 degree of longitude that has a uniform legally mandated standard time, usually referred to as the local time. By convention, there are 24 main time zones on the earth. The time at 0 degree longitude is Greenwich Mean Time, GMT. To complete one rotation, the earth takes 24 hours from west to east. During this rotation, each meridian passes under the direct rays of the sun. Indian Standard Time. Indian Standard Time, IST, is the time observed throughout India and Sri Lanka with the time offset of GMT plus 5:30. Indian Standard Time is located on the basis of 82.5 degree east longitude, which is just to the west of the town of Mirzapur near Allahabad in the state of Uttar Pradesh.